The owner of this truck brought it in with a complaining of a pedal that feels harder than it used to. Now, when a pedal feels harder than it used to, there could be a couple different things, but the first thing we really think about is the brake booster. Now, with the booster, I've got a booster right here I'm going to talk about for a second. It's easier to show you than here. A booster really consists of a metal container with a rubber diaphragm in the middle. Now, there's vacuum on both sides of that rubber diaphragm. The vacuum is being supplied by the engine, going into this check valve right here. Now, we already checked to see if this engine can produce 18 inches of vacuum, and it does, so that should be plenty enough for this booster. You need at least 15, 16 inches of vacuum. Like I said, this one has 18, so that's plenty. So if you have vacuum on both sides of that diaphragm, it's holding that diaphragm right in the middle. This is called, it's just a vacuum suspended diaphragm. And what'll happen is when you hit the brake pedal, this is hooked up to your brake pedal. When you hit your brake pedal, you open up a valve inside here. Now that lets air come rushing inside this half, this back half of the diaphragm. Well, when that air gets in there and you got vacuum on this side, you have air pressure on this side, atmospheric pressure basically, it pushes that rubber diaphragm. The rubber diaphragm is hooked up to your pedal assembly also to help you push the brake pedal. If you don't have this power assist, you're doing all the work by yourself. If you have the power assist, it's going to help you. The larger the diameter of this booster, the more assist you get. So what we're going to do now is we check to see if we have enough vacuum. Now we're going to check to see if the vacuum check valve works. This check valve should hold vacuum inside this canister for at least two or three emergency stops. And when I mean emergency stops, I mean if the engine dies, you lose your vacuum source. So what they do is they put a check valve here to keep vacuum in here so you can get the vehicle pulled over to the side of the road with power assist. You'll only get two or three assists with it, but that should be enough to get you off the street and get off to the side of the road and try to restart your vehicle. So I'm gonna pull that check valve off right now, and we should hear like a whooshing noise. You'll hear it here. Hopefully you'll hear it. Let's see if the check valve's working properly. That was it. That was holding vacuum inside this booster. So now I'm going to put this back on. We're going to go inside the vehicle. We're going to actually start the vehicle up while I'm pushing the brake pedal down. Now that I know there's no vacuum in here, or I can pump the brake pedal to make sure there's no vacuum in the system at all, then while I'm holding my foot on the brake pedal, I'm going to start the vehicle. My brake pedal should drop down. Okay, we've checked everything under the hood already. We have 18 inches of vacuum. The check valve is operating properly. So now the next test is to actually see if the power booster is working properly. Now the way we're gonna do that in this particular vacuum booster is we're gonna pump the brake pedal 6-8 times, whatever it takes to get a hard pedal. Then I'm gonna keep my foot on the brake pedal. We're gonna start the truck up. And what should happen is the pedal should drop and get that power assist feel. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. So I'm gonna pump the brake pedal here. Okay, that's pretty hard right there. I'm gonna hold it down. Oh yeah. She dropped right down just like it's supposed to. Not to the floor, just to where it should be without power assist.